Hey guys, and welcome to today's Flat Earth Idiots video. Today's video is going to be covering the Flat Earth Godfather, or as I like to call him, Flat Earth Dumbo, Mark Sargent and his recent appearance on Good Morning, a UK-based TV show. Now, for copyright reasons, I had to cut out the unused portions, so there will be a link in the description if you want to watch the full interview. Now, today's video is the first of my remastered videos, which are just newer, upgraded versions of the videos that YouTube removed when I was hacked. So sit back, relax, and let's laugh at this flat earther together. And oh yeah, I'll be reading and reacting to your comments in a future video, so I look forward to your creativity. So let's begin.
Of the leading voices in the Flat Earth movement.
And I love when Mark Sargent and other people refer to him as the Flat Earth leader. That's not something I'd brag about. That's like bragging about being the oldest kid in the third grade because it's your third time through. Mark Sargent, you're an idiot.
Well, Mark joins us now.
Welcome.
Good morning, Mark.
Welcome.
I mean, obviously, there are thousands of questions,
yes.
Which I'm sure you've been asked a thousand times.
A few, yes.
I find it funny that Mark Sargent and all other Flat Earth idiots still believe in the Flat Earth when they can't even answer the most basic of questions. Not to mention, Flat Earthers fail to provide a Flat Earth model that we can test and criticize. I mean, I'm surprised more Flat Earthers don't still believe in Santa Claus.
Now we can see that it's actually round.
Sure.
But we've seen that it's round.
Sure.
So how come it's not?
It's not because we can't prove it's a globe.
When are these degenerate idiots gonna learn that science has the responsibility of disproving bad ideas like the flat earth and not proving good ones? It might sound counterintuitive, but it's actually true. For a scientific theory to be considered valid and accepted, it must first be falsifiable.
Everything that we've, in fact, it starts out with everybody that's in the Flat Earth community starts out looking at the globe saying, can you prove it? Mm-hmm. Can you prove the globe, especially without using NASA? Because it's not that we found out that the world was a globe back in 1972. We knew for five centuries.
Hold on. Did Mark Sargent just say that mankind has known it's a globe for centuries? Isn't that what we've been saying for the past few years, Mark? You're an idiot.
So that's how everyone starts. You try to prove it in a court of law.
Court of law? Are you serious? As if a judge who's an expert on law would also be an expert in determining the validity of scientific claims. Now, what you could do is take your evidence to the court of science and see how fast you get laughed out of that courtroom. That is the best way you deal with a flat earth idiot. Just point and laugh.
He'll come out and tell you that no civilian will ever be able to see the curvature of the Earth.
Because so is he lying?
No, I'm not saying that you're lying. I'm saying that you wanted to see the curvature. There's a big difference.
But how is that any different than a flat earther walking outside and saying it's flat because everywhere they look, it looks flat? By your logic, isn't it possible, even probable, that those idiots are just seeing what they want to see?
And that's live pictures from the space station now.
Right.
All a lie.
Again, started from the American military. Yes, absolutely. I'm saying it's worse than that.
So what is that then? What am I looking at if I'm not looking at live pictures?
You're looking at CGI.
CGI.
Oh, I'm not saying there's something up there. No question. Is there a vehicle that could be the ISS up there? Yeah. Are there people inside it? No. Not a chance. And you can look at the interior footage and the production value is horrible. I challenge anybody.
Are you really saying that you think the ISS is fake due to its poor production value? Did you forget that the ISS is moving at almost 17,000 miles per hour and it's orbiting the Earth? Or maybe you just forgot that everything inside, including the astronauts, are experiencing microgravity and are essentially just floating around on the inside of the space station. It's almost as if they designed the ISS to be a space laboratory and not a space movie set. Mark Sargent, you're an idiot.
We've got some...
We've interviewed Tim Peake from this sofa.
I know. And
so what was I doing? Who was I talking to? Where was he?
You were talking to a military officer, nothing more. I talked to Terry Virts, you know, American astronaut. And look, they're all... You gotta remember, everybody that goes up there are high-ranking military.
Mark Sargent's an idiot, and this is a flat-out lie. While it is very expensive to go to space, civilians can actually purchase tickets to visit the ISS. Here's a clip from KLBJ 93.7 of a flat earther and a civilian astronaut having a debate. Notice the face on the flat earther when he finds out that he's actually talking to someone who's been to space and seen the spherical earth with his own eyes.
Aboard which Russian ship?
10 years ago this week.
10 years ago this week.
I flew on the Russian Soyuz up, to live for 2 weeks on the International Space Station.
Had to learn a lot of stuff and qualify.
Including Sachasnaya Ruski Azik. Yeah, so even the Russian language, which was actually
what did
the hardest
part. So what is your opening statement?
Well, first I'd like to tell you that I do know that the Earth is round by personal direct observation. I spent 2 weeks in orbit around the Earth.
Why? What's the point of faking it?
Well, that's one of the bigger questions, which is why keep this thing a secret? And we're talking about...
No, but why fake it?
Because if you don't fake it, eventually the private industry is going to get involved, and then they're going to find out on their own.
I'm sorry, but this is just a lazy man's answer. If the Earth were truly flat, the competitive nature of the private industry would have them knowing first. Especially the communication industry, which is always looking for the most effective and efficient way of transmitting data over long distances. Don't you think that if the Earth were flat, they'd be the first ones to take advantage of it and break the silence? But for some reason, everyone in the communications industry still operates as if they're limited by the dimensions of a spherical Earth. Mark Sargent, you're an idiot.
This is
and why that would be bad because...
What the fuck was that noise, Mark?
So pilots are involved in this?
No, not at all. Pilots, scientists, none of those people. I have astrophysicists, Brian Cox, none of them have anything to do with it.
But at the same time, scientists are smart enough to know that the Earth is not flat. For instance, if a scientist designed an experiment that relied on the downward acceleration of gravity, then the absence of gravity would give the scientist unexpected results, and the scientist would know. So why do you think that we don't see thousands of scientists rushing to journals to prove that gravity doesn't exist? Well, that's simple. Because gravity exists. The Earth's not flat, and all flat earthers are fucking idiots.
I mean, it's no different. Look, generals know the battle plans, but most of the officers below them
were
don't.
Were the Apollo, those massive Apollo...
We've been to the moon, right?
What's up with Mark Sargent making all these weird noises? First it was... Then it was... Sounds to me like somebody's getting a bit nervous. Maybe it's because a woman other than his mother is sitting close to him, or maybe he realizes that he's getting dangerously close to being exposed as the flat earth idiot con man that he really is.
Those Apollo rockets that went up into the air, did they go?
They didn't go anywhere. They just went off into the ocean and ditched. Again, I'm an American.
Please don't remind us.
Look, we're taught, you know, rah, rah, go team, wave the flag. And so it's tough for me because I love the American space program.
No, you don't. You don't love the American space program. You dickweeds talk shit about NASA every chance you get. You say that space doesn't exist. How can you love the space program? You are an idiot.
We're saying that we live on a flat, enclosed world that is basically, you're basically living in a big soundstage with walls and a floor and a ceiling.
The Truman Show.
The Truman Show. Yeah, very, very, very similar.
Really? The Truman Show? Well, if that's the case, then there are several questions that need to be answered. Like, who operates this massive stage? Where do the enormous amounts of resources that would be needed for a global production of this size come from? Who built this stage, and on what foundation does this movie set rest on? And if any one of your answers predicates on the existence of a supernatural being with smelly sandal feet, then you are the idiot.
That is so big that even our best and brightest didn't figure it out until about 1960. And when they did, decide to keep it a secret.
I love when conspiratards like Mark Sargent say that there's evidence out there, but just everybody's keeping it a secret. Like, no one's ever divulged this paradigm-changing secret to any family member or on their deathbed. And our best and brightest scientists? Well, they know. They just don't think it's worth studying or telling anyone else about. And yeah, you're probably thinking the same thing that I am. Sounds like bullshit. And if there's one thing that my mama taught me, it was that if it looks like bullshit, and sounds like bullshit, and smells like bullshit, it's probably a flat earth idiot.
The really, really short version is you don't live on a globe. This is what it looks like on the outside. That's what it looks like on the inside. There you go.
No, the short version is that you and all the other short bus flat earthers are a bunch of fucking idiots. Neither one of those models comports to reality, and neither one of those models could give us any predictive power whatsoever regarding anything.
So right. Why don't we just fall off the edge?
For the same reason, the space asteroid question.
You got that one backwards, Mark. The space asteroid is the globe Earth. The snow globe pizza wonderland for idiots? That's the flat Earth.
Yeah. So why don't, for the same reason why you don't fall off the edge here, Antarctica is the only continent that doesn't look like anything else. All the other continents in here look perfectly fine.
On a globe, Antarctica looks just as normal as any other continent. It's only on the flat Earth model that Antarctica looks all jacked up like that. Now, there is a question that all flat earthers need to answer. When cartographers first mapped out the Antarctic coastline, they measured it to be about 17,000 kilometers long. On a flat Earth map, the Antarctic coastline would need to be at least 70,000 kilometers long. So, flat earthers, where's the missing 53,000 kilometers? Exactly, Mark. The Earth's not flat, and you're an idiot.
Yep.
So where's the North Pole?
North Pole's in the center. North Pole's in the center. South Pole doesn't exist.
Well, if the South Pole doesn't exist, then somebody needs to go down to the South Pole Observatory and tell all the scientists they're freezing their ass off for nothing. And why is it then that any and all observers in the Southern Hemisphere can look due south and see a rotation point in the sky? Also, why is the angular elevation of that rotation point dependent upon the observer's latitude? Both are strong indicators that the Earth is spherical and rotates, and both 100% exclude the possibility that the Earth is flat. Sorry, flat earthers, but the Earth's not flat. And you guys are idiots.
Most people don't talk about that. The Antarctic Treaty says that no corporation in the history of the world can set up shop down there forever.
The Antarctic Treaty is designed for environmental preservation and the logistical and scientific coordination between politically competing countries. It ensures two things. One, that we don't fuck up the last remaining untouched environment on Earth. And two, that we don't militarize it. If flat earth idiots are going to continue to bring up the Antarctic Treaty, then they should really go back to school and learn how to read first.
What's outside?
That's a tough one, isn't it?
Well, I mean, because you could have no clue.
If you can't get outside, you're not going to know for sure. But I mean, I don't think, you know, my personal opinion is this isn't a one-off. There's not just one of these, there's more.
Well, it's too bad you don't have any evidence to support those claims, Mark. And it astounds me as to how much fantasy these flat earth dipshits will accept, all while denying reality around them. I mean, ask Mark Sargent about these additional pond earths that nobody's ever seen before, and he'll tell you they probably exist. But show him the thousands of pictures of the actual earth taken from space, and he's 100% convinced that all those are fake. Well, Mark, you got me 100% convinced that you're an idiot.
Amongst your flat earthers, you argue amongst yourselves as well.
Like the Scottish Islands, we argue.
You have been accused yourself as being sort of a member, I think, of Warner Brothers or something. You're making this up.
Government agent. Yeah.
So,
don't worry, Mark. Nobody believes what flat earth idiots say anyways. And don't you think that if the government was going to send somebody to corrupt the flat earthers from the inside, they had sent somebody more competent than the adult version of Porky Pig?
I mean, aren't you just all turning on yourselves? Like, you can't believe anything.
No.
Even your own.
At the end of the day, again, like the Scottish Highlands, no offense, but, you know, they can all agree on one thing. They hate the English. That's the same sort of thing here. We disagree on so many of the finer points here. But at the end of the day, we all agree on one thing. That is not a globe.
Yeah, it is kind of hilarious. While you fucking idiots are arguing over whose model doesn't fit reality the least, us globers are all sitting back, relaxing, spending time with our family, and enjoying our good-paying full-time jobs.
And you can absolutely hammer on the globe. Everybody starts out hating flat Earth, and everybody tears down the globe themselves. That's why we have a 99% retention rate.
Well, unless there's 78 million flat Earth idiots, which, thank God there's not, the globe Earth still has a higher retention rate.
What proof do you have?
Got it.
No one has ever been there.
Got it.
No one has ever seen, taken any pictures of the ice wall that surrounds us.
Exactly.
So no one can get anywhere near. Why can't we go there? Why can't I?
Oh, the Antarctic Treaty. And you can go there. If you want to spend, I think it's like £12,000, you can go to the edge, one of the peninsulas, and get your picture taken with penguins.
With all his TV appearances and his appearance on the Netflix docu-comedy, Behind the Curve, combined with the financial freedom that comes with living with your mother into your mid-40s, you would think that Mark Sargent would have saved up enough money by now to buy himself a ticket to go to Antarctica and prove once and for all that there is in fact a militarized penguin army guarding the ice wall. I guess he'd rather save thousands of dollars than waste that money destroying his own beliefs.
No, I want to see the wall.
Well,
no,
well, I mean, the wall itself just extends for a long... You can get to the Antarctic coastline. That's not a problem.
Yeah. I want to go to the wall.
Boy, you're going to go all the way in here? No, the Antarctic Treaty forbids it. You cannot go there. It's locked in. It's the only unbroken treaty in the history of treaty. So,
not only is this wrong, as there have been several unbroken treaties in our history, it's not even the oldest one. The treaty between England and Portugal still stands as the longest unbroken treaty between countries. I still don't understand why flat earthers just spit out demonstrably false facts as if they know them to be true. Never mind. I just remembered, the flat earth audience is full of gullible morons, which happens to be a prerequisite for becoming a full-fledged flat earth idiot.
To your proof questions, and I know we don't have a whole lot of time left. Sorry, let me give you the five bullet points that I gave a Georgetown physicist, and he folded like a card table almost immediately. I put this challenge out to Brian Cox, Neil deGrasse Tyson, Michio Kaku, any of these guys.
Oh, this is going to be great. It's not every day that you get to hear what inspired a man to become a window licker.
First one would be long-distance photography. Curvature of the Earth is 8 inches per mile squared. We eventually should not be able to see over the hill. We should be a hill. It should be gone. HD technology has changed that. Now we can see things way, way further. It's some wonderful work being done by Nathan Oakley and some UK teams where they're actually seeing a horizon behind oil platforms at 10, 15, 20 miles.
We've already covered the black swan observations. Those observations only prove two things. One, that refraction actually exists and can cause objects to look closer than or further from the horizon, depending upon atmospheric conditions. And two, that flat earth idiots have no idea what refraction is or how it actually works.
Gravity versus the vacuum of space. Gravity's holding things down, right? That's gravity, no problem, right? You make the upper part of this a vacuum chamber, you pull a cork, everything's gonna rush upstairs. Well, why, when you go outside, why isn't the air outside rushing into space?
You can't,
the atmosphere. Why doesn't go into space? Can't say gravity anymore, because gravity didn't hold the air in this room for that little test.
Well, if you had a container that was tall enough, then you wouldn't necessarily have any atmosphere at the top of it. And you can test this for yourself. Just take a deflated balloon, put it over a plastic bottle, and drive up a mountain. One thing you'll notice is that as you increase in elevation, you decrease in atmospheric pressure and density. And if you continued to go up, there would be a point at which there was simply no atmosphere at all. What's next, Mark?
Third, the moon eclipse is too small. The moon eclipse is 70 miles wide and the moon is 2,000 miles wide. We never see that in nature. The moon eclipse cannot, we say the moon is about 70 miles wide.
Oh my goodness, you're such an idiot. What do you mean we don't see this in nature? Due to the sun being larger than the earth, we literally see this everywhere in nature. Anytime a shadow is cast by an object that's smaller than the light source, there's going to be an umbra and penumbra that is smaller and larger than the object casting the shadow respectively.
Fourth would be the moon temperature. That's a spooky one. I didn't even know that till about two years in, which is the moon generates a cold light.
No, it doesn't, you idiot. Due to the well-understood physics of light, we know that light doesn't cool things down. Not to mention that any time a cold moonlight experiment is done under controlled conditions, the results always suggest that moonlight has no cooling effect whatsoever.
Which is warmer in the moon shade than it is in the moonlight.
Radiative cooling and convection heating are a thing and are absolutely responsible for heating up the shaded areas at night, but we have yet to reach maximum stupid.
If you magnify moonlight, it gets even colder. It's generating a cold laser light. It doesn't even make sense.
You went full retard, man.
Well, there you go, boys and girls. Mark Sargent has officially gone full retard.
Never go full retard.
The moonlight is a cold laser light, and with a magnifying glass, you can intensify its effect. No, that is not how it works at all. The moon does not give off a cold light, let alone does it give off a cooling laser light, and flat earthers are a bunch of dumbass idiots.
And the last question, which is the Van Allen radiation trap question, which is, are the Van Allen radiation belts deadly? Yes or no?
The Van Allen radiation belts have nothing to do with the shape of the Earth. And if those 5 points are your best pieces of evidence for the flat Earth, then I'm more convinced today than I was yesterday that the shape of the Earth is a globe and that flat earthers are a bunch of fucking idiots. All right, guys, I think that's going to be where we end the video today. If you found this video interesting, then give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. Now, I do want to say thank you to Mark Sargent, who did actually take time out of his day to give me an interview at the Flat Earth International Conference in Dallas. I'll post the link in the description if you'd like to watch the full uncut interview. And finally, a massive shout out to all of my channel members and patrons whose support helps me keep doing what I love to do, calling out idiots on the internet. I'm Team Skeptic. And I'm out.